today we are gonna talk about the plumbing services. I mean all about the complete plumbing over here, and we'll be dealing with this plumbing in the terms of the mechanical electrical plumbing, which is also known as the building services. So I'm talking about a part of building services that is nothing but I'm talking about one service among a building service that is only about the plumbing. So let's move on with this. I do have some content with me. We'll be dealing in this manner. So first of all, just let me get into this. And if you see over here, today we'll be talking about the first chapter in this manner. Okay, so all you can see over here, we know this, that plumbing is divided into two parts. First is the water supply or the water system, and the second is the drainage system. So we all are over here to just discuss about some basics all about the plumbing. So let's proceed in this manner. Very first is what the introduction. So you people know this, what is all about the introduction over here. Let's discuss in this manner. So as I said, we are dealing in the building service that is nothing but a mechanical, electrical and plumbing, which is also known as MEP. It's also called as the building services. So I'm dealing with one service as of now, that is nothing but the plumbing service. Okay, so let's deal with this. So as you people know this, this is mechanical, electrical, plumbing and services is a significant component of the construction supply chain. As you people know this, now this is given a huge priority because MEP is the biggest service among the service in the building services. So that's why this is given a huge amount of priority, because it's among this services, among all building services, this is a biggest service over here. And the moment it is biggest service, it is what the pricing also a bit higher when compared with the different services. Comparing to the different services, that means we do have a number of services. And if you can see over here, there rather than this MEP, we do have electrical, HVAC and plumbing and firefighting. These all services is nothing but MEP services. Moreover, we do have elevator service, solar, gas, security and BMS. Now these are all services also included in a project. Okay, but as I said, among all, this is given a huge priority. So, and we know this, not only this MEP services will be having a complete plumbing, I mean this not only having a complete kind of building over here, because this is inside the building, we do have is this services which is for human comfort and all this. Okay, for the facility of the living style, you can say, in this manner. So these all service or more services will be combining, and it will be having one creating a one building. It might be commercial or residential for a better way of living. So let's move on, as we are here just to discuss about the plumbing. So first of all, let's see what is plumbing over here. In general, I'll say plumbing is nothing but it's a flow of water in a through piping, I say, or I can say flow of water or any fluid through piping. This is in general. But as per if you see in regards of this plumbing, what we are dealing about in this over here. So let me tell you about this. Now plumbing is a system of piping and apparatus and fixture for water distribution and waste disposal within a building. So that means it's a set of piping, you can say, or it's a system of piping that has been attached to apparatus and fixture for the water distribution and waste disposal within a building. That means at the same time it needs water for some fixtures, at the same time the water should be drained from that fixtures unit. So over here within a building, so it's basically a combined, a kind of system, you can say. It's not only something which is only water supply, but what about the drainage? And so basically when you combine all the services, it's a system of piping, because it's a system over here. So this is a plumbing, or else in short you can say it's nothing but a set of pipes, or else you can say flow of water or any or the fluid through the piping is nothing but a plumbing. Now let's talk about what is a plumbing system. Now first of all, we are dealing mostly with the residential projects over here. So I'll just give a definition in regards of the residential project. A residential plumbing system is a network of supply water supply pipes, drain pipes and vent pipes. So there are three things over here in the project. Not only the water supply, I need drain at the same time to drain the water, I mean the wastewater or the soil water, whatever it might be, whatever the drain is. And for sure I need vent pipes also, just to vent or to exhaust the gases out from the project. Okay, so these are the three things over here, which is a network in a plumbing system, you can say, which has a supply of water, the drain and the vents. So this is a plumbing system. Now, as I said you previously, now plumbing is divided into two parts. First is water supply and second is drainage. Now, further, this is classified into five piping networks under plumbing. First is over here water supply, and under water supply you'll be getting is hot water and cold water. And second, in this drainage, you'll be getting under drainage. There are three kind of systems over here. That is wastewater, soil, and surface water. Now we'll see what is wastewater, soil, and surface water. Now, cold water is nothing but a water which is being served or which is being supplied from the municipal directly to the project. Now, hot water is something that I get a municipal water from the municipal, and it travels along through the piping and it goes to the heater, where the water gets heated up and the water is been again served to the concerned project or to the concerned service. That is hot water. Nothing but this is hot water when being of an equipment, it's been heated up. So that's a heater over here. And in the drainage, as I said, waste, soil, and surface. Now, wastewater is something the water coming out from what? Except you can say WC and urinals, it's a wastewater, because soil water or soil pipe is something which is carrying out the drain or which is carrying out the waste from the WC and urinals. So this is a soil pipe, you can say, or a soil water. Nothing but you can say, in short, carrying out waste from the WCs and urinals. Except this is wastewater. Now you can consider this wastewater in terms of the from the kitchen sinks, from the showers. Okay, and these all kind of things you can consider in terms of wastewater. Surface water is something you can now consider this in terms of a roof system. I mean the roof drain. So that means in case of rain and all this, the water collected at the surface of the roof. Okay, it needs to be drained out. So this is the thing which we need to have. So this is a surface water, nothing but the roof water. We need to drain these things over here in this in the drainage system. And this is a water supply, cold and hot water things over here. This is just an picture of how exactly plumbing. So you can see these are called as fixtures. Like we are seeing, this is lavatory, this is WC, and this is a systematic arrangement. Not only demands for the flush, at the same time it demands the drain water. So to drain, this is you can say as a soil pipe over here, and this pipe which is connected to the lavatory is nothing but the wastewater. And there are some fittings over here. Now this is called as a trap over here. There are some more fittings. Now as you can see, here is elbow, and here is T. So this is all you can combinely, you can say it's a system for the piping and in terms of plumbing. So this is just an idea how this things goes on and all this. So there are some standard societies in the terms of plumbing. So very first and commonly known is what IPC, that is nothing but International Plumbing Codes. Now International Plumbing Codes is generally being accepted commonly because as it is international, so it has been globally accepted throughout the world. That's why it is International Plumbing Codes. Now UPC again is a code. Generally you'll be seeing this in Gulf countries. And British Standard, the British Standard, UK. Like example, if you're working in UK and all this, so you'll be having these standards in the UK because they'll be having this their own codes. Okay, and DEWA, this is Dubai Electricity and Water Authority. This is from what? UAE, NBC in India, IPA in India, Association Qatar, Kharama in Qatar. Now let us talk about the standard societies. What are the needs of the standard societies? But before this, what does this society does first of all? This standard society is nothing but this what you're seeing over here. They generate codes over here. Code is nothing but you can say a value, and we get this value based on the experiences of the research and development team, where they have researching on some XYZ region. Now you can say, now IPC, they have been researching on the entire world, and there'll be some codes. For example, as we know this, if I'm working in any project, if I'm near the seashore, I'll be getting, okay, I could not go for a GI kind of material for the piping. I need to go with a plastic category or stainless steel, because I got to know this as per my information or as per my knowledge that it could not be used over here, because there are chances of what? Humidity is very high over there, so chances of corrosion is very quick and rapid. So where did I get this values, or where did I get this knowledge from? From some codes or societies, as you can see over here. So this is IPC. They gives me a value. For example, I can say I'll get a ready-made value, not only about the materials, I'll be getting a ready-made value with reference. Like example, this WC is demands how much of water per flush and how much of pressure it requires, how much amount of water with respect to all the fixtures. Same likewise in UPC and British standards, they'll be saying these kind of codes. Like example, not only to the fixtures, with the respect to the people also. Like example, if you talk about in this UPC and IPC, I'll be getting the minimum number of the fixtures, and I get to know what fixture demands how much amount of water in terms of GPM or whatever the unit is, and not only the GPM, it demands some amount of with pressure also. So both the things will be getting in this detail in the standard societies over here. So let's see over here one by one, one by one. But let me tell you, like I said, UPC and British standards, if you're working for a company which is in UK based, okay, so they'll be following this standards, because this they get the values based on their community in that region. They have been specialized and they have done some research and they got some values, so that I get a ready-made value so that I can use this value and I can proceed up with the calculation part or the selection of the pipes and all this, I mean the diameters and all this. So based on these things, I'll be getting help. And not only over this, because when I submit a design over here, I need to give a reference, okay, that I do have taken this units, or I do have taken this values from XYZ standard that is listed below over here, you can see. So I need to submit this to that. I have taken this values from this standards and all this. But what is the need over here? Let's see. What is the need of this plumbing codes? As I just now said, a plumbing code is a code that provides regulations for the design, installation, and inspection of building for plumbing and sanitary system. What we have discussed just now, it provides some regulations with respect to the design and installation, how the things should be installed, and inspection of the building for plumbing and sanitary system, the same kind of thing. So that means you'll be getting help in terms of the designing purpose and in the installation purpose by using this international plumbing codes or any code from the plumbing. Okay. Now, what is the need of this? This is what is plumbing code. What is the need of this codes? Now let me tell you, plumbing design based on a probability, except special cases like ablution tap, residential school, therefore to design plumbing standards and codes are required. Now as I just now said, always remember the moment I said plumbing and the MEP services, the moment I said plumbing, you need to make sure that plumbing is maximum casesly designed on the probability. Now what do you mean by probability? Probability is nothing but the chances. Like I'll say you, it is based on the chances only, but except special cases, and that special cases I can say as a peak demand. Okay, and what are the peak demand? That is ablution tap and residential schools over here. Now let me elaborate this a bit more for you people. The plumbing design is based on the probability. Now what do you mean by probability? I just now said probability is nothing but just to the chances. For example, everyone just consider that I do have a bathroom, okay, in one project, and in that bathroom I got to know there is one WC, one shower, okay, and one lavatory and one water bidet. So these are four fixtures over there in one bathroom. So now do you people think this that all four fixtures will be utilized or is being used at the same time? For sure no, because one person or maximum of two persons, one person only, they might be using this, isn't it? Per person, maximum one person or two person will be using. So there is a very less chances that all the fixtures might be getting used at the same time. So it's very difficult to proceed up with this for the four fixtures designing of the pipe. So that's why we do the designing of the plumbing with respect to the probability basis. That means I'll be getting this probability value or the probability unit from the what? The codes over here, what we just now discussed about. And those fixturing require water must be, as you can see over here, but special cases. Now what do you mean by special cases? Now special cases like ablution taps. Now it's talking about the ablution taps, and one more he's talking about the residential school. Now, ablution tap and residential school, it's been clearly mentioned it's a special case. Now, why it's special? Because it is based on the peak demand. That means we know this ablution tap, our work worship area, we know this. For example, we do have a prayer at that specific time. So what we have before the prayer, everyone comes over there, perform ablution over there. So we know this, the number of taps in that ablution area is maximum be used for the maximum time in this limited amount of time. There are chances maximumly that all the taps will be working at the same time. Likewise with the residential school, like the kids or the students stay over there in the residential school. When they're done with the school, they go to the residence, which is again in the school premises. So what they do is, when the moment again they're back to school the next day, they'll be getting up early in the morning, like 5 or 6, and they'll be doing their activities daily. So what happens over there? There are again chances that all the showers or all the WCs at the same time will be using for a specific amount of time. But it's not about the time, it's about what I need to design in such a way that if at all, whatever the fixtures in that area, I need to consider that all will be getting used at the same time. So this is a peak demand. But previously, what I know this among as a general, as I said, a bathroom for fixtures, there are very less chances that I might get that all the four fixtures will be working at the same time, isn't it? So therefore, I need to check that what kind of project am I dealing with. If I'm dealing with a project which is generally a residential project or a commercial project, I need to recheck, or I need to check with it. Okay, whether I'm dealing with a residential or commercial project. If you're dealing with such kind of projects like ablution area and all this, then you could not proceed in a probability basis. Then you need to check as per the project, you need to think, and you need to proceed for the design. Okay, so therefore, to design to plumbing standards and codes are required. That means for the designing purpose, I need this codes. If I don't have this kind of codes, then it will be difficult for me to proceed out with. Okay, so now next is what? Where a building contains plumbing fixtures, those fixtures water must be provided with an adequate supply of water for proper operation. What does this mean? This means what? Where a building contains plumbing fixtures. Now, as I said just now, plumbing fixture is something, let's discuss plumbing fixture in general. As of now, to avoid confusion, let me say you, a plumbing fixture is nothing but a kind of, this all those fixtures, like as I can say, WC is a fixture, lavatory is a fixture, okay, shower is a fixture, bathtub is a fixture. These are all plumbing fixtures, okay. And I got to know that these fixtures will be demanding some amount of water, and that what amount of water? An adequate supply of water. That means a sufficient amount of water supply for their proper operation. Now let me relate this. For example, if I'm having a lavatory, lavatory is nothing but a wash basin. So lavatory demands a very less amount of water when compared with a shower. So the difference of the water supply to this and this would be differentiating, because as this is for the different service, this is a shower is for having bath, and this is for just for cleaning your lavatory, I can say, just for your hand wash and all this. So limited amount of water over there. Here the amount of water or the water supply is different. If I don't provide this amount of water, what they are adequate supply of, so what happens over there? The proper functioning of the fixture will not be done, okay, and it will not serve the purpose. So therefore, to have these things to perform all the fixtures working in a proper manner, I need to supply an adequate supply of water. Don't worry, we'll be saying this as per the code. So codes will be helping us how and what should be the adequate supply of water for each and every fixture has been given. We'll be seeing this, okay. And moreover, apart from this, if you see here, the number of required plumbing fixtures is specified by this code and is based upon the anticipated maximum number of occupants for the building. And the type is what? And the type of building occupancy. That means one should know, first of all, If the plumbing fixtures, for example, if there is no plumbing fixtures given from an architect, so what do you mean by this? So do not get confused that if it's not being given from an architect, what you need to do is you need to first of all read the project. If it's not given the fixtures over there, need not worry, we can have this by using the code. Okay, the minimum required fixtures I can do this, I'll be showing you. But how you can do this is based upon, if you see over here, the ma anticipated maximum number of occupants. First of all, you need to know how many number of occupants is there in the project or in that building. Now, it might be differing from something, like it might be commercial, residential, whatever it might be. First of all, you need to know the number of occupants in the building and the type of the building occupancy. Again, what do you mean by this type of the building occupancy? It is residential, then we do have a huge number of things in the residential. If it's commercial, we do have subcategories in the commercial. The same thing what it's talking about. So if I have this much of information, I can find out the minimum number of plumbing fixtures in the any kind of project if I know the maximum number of occupants over here. Now this code provides prospective criteria for the pipe sizing systems connected to those fixtures. While having this, as per the fixtures and all this, one can find out the what prescriptive criteria for the pipe sizing. That is nothing but improbable, as you can say, or you can say what a peak demand as per the project now. But the main gist over here, I can size a pipe size based on the fixtures. Okay, it might be probability as per, it might be as per the peak demand. Is again, this both depends on what? This both depends on the project. Okay, through the use of the code, approved materials and the installation requirements specified in this code, plumbing system will perform to their intended life over of life of the building. Now, what do you mean by this? Through the use of this code, approved materials and the installation. As I said, we know this in some services, like if I'm having a, this not this depends, the material depends on the type of the project. For example, if you're dealing with commercial or if you're dealing with a residential project, we need to check very importantly in this area or for this project. For example, if it's like an residential project and I'm using for the water supply system, so the material would be, I need to check that this material is being approved. That means approved in a sense that is not harmful for the human, so I can make use of the transferring of the water in this manner. For example, it might be for the drain side also. Just talking about why approvals, because we got to know this. Okay, when such kind of thing has been passed, like this amount of liquid or this amount of fluid or this kind of fluid or liquid, whatever it might be, it's been passing, so it should not get contact with the material. So that means I can say in short that I got to select a material which is safe for human beings, as I'm dealing with plumbing thing, and mostly will be what fluid we do use over here, mostly for the water supply, isn't it? It might be for the water supply for the drinking purpose, or it might be for the water supply towards the circulating water to the complete the project, isn't it? So I need to know. Likewise, what I need to know, for example, if I'm circulating a hot water throughout the complete project, and I need to know this, that it could not be, because every pipe has some kind of pressure bearing, I need to know, okay, this much of pressure it can bear and this much of temperature it can bear. If I'm exceeding more than that, that material could not. So I need to know all these things. So where I'll be getting this approved material? So they'll be giving us that this should be done from over here, this kind of material should be used in this kind of place and here and all this, and how the installation should be done in respect of the project. Okay, so now these are the things over here what we have discussed. As I just now said, we'll be seeing this, the containing fixtures, plumbing, and I said now, first of all, in an adequate water supply. So I'll be showing you something I do have is, first of all, this one code over here, that is nothing but International Plumbing Code. It's one book with me. So let me just say you, first of all, in the chapter 6, if you go in this, and the table number is chapter number 6. Okay, so as you can see over here, this is chapter number 6 and page number, as I said, 55 online. So this you see over here, this is table number 604.3, the water distribution system design criteria. First of all, I said you that what we have read the theory over here. If you see, here are the fixtures and here are the flow rates of the fixture in the terms of GPM, and this is the pressure required, because both the things is important. If I do have the flow but not the pressure, it will not serve the purpose. If I do have pressure but not the flow rate or the Q, it's again not worth it. So both the things are important. So now let's talk about something. Let's see about the shower over here. So if you talk about a shower demands 3 gallons per hour. That is GPM. Sorry, GPM stands for gallons per minute. I said GPH. Sorry about that. This is shower. So this demands GPM. That is gallons per minute. That means it should be supplied with 3 gallons of water per minute and with a pressure of required 8 PSI. Okay. So it's not only this. All the fixtures you can see over here. This is urinal with valve. It demands 12 GPM with 25 PSI. Now if you see laundry tray, lavatory demands 2 GPM with 8 PSI. So in this manner, one can find out how much. If I don't provide this, he was saying some adequate amount of water supply. If I don't provide this adequate amount of water supply, for example, if I'm going with 2 GPM, it will not gonna work. Isn't it? So that's what for sure what we need to do is we need to proceed up. We need to check that we are giving a sufficient amount of water so that it can work in a proper manner with this much of pressure. So both the things has been mandatory, flow and pressure. Okay, I mean the Q and the pressure. So this one thing has been completed. What is we are saying with adequate water supply of proper operation. Now there was something second point what they are saying, the number of plumbing fixtures can be find out in this manner. So this is on the page number 40 and the table number is 403.1. This is minimum number of fixtures or minimum number of required plumbing fixtures. Now if you see over here, there are classification, occupancy, description, and these are the minimum number of fixtures what you are seeing over here. This is water closets, this is lavatories, bathtubs and drinking fountain. So this is basic need: WC, lavatories, bathtub, drinking fountain and others. Now for example, if you see over here, in this WCs we do have 2 sections, male and female, lavatory 2 sections, male and female, bathtub single and drinking fountain single. Now let's take for example, if they are saying that your project of occupancy or the classification is like educational, you can say for example you're dealing with the educational project. Now you can say educational refers to any college or any institute and all this. So it's over here. So what do you mean by this 1 per 50? What do you mean by this? Here this means is nothing but I do have is what? It's nothing male and female. Here is saying this in education I need 1 per 50. That means in the 50 members or in the 50 people, we need 1 WC and we need 1 laboratory in terms of 50 people. No bathtub because I'm dealing with educational. It's not a residential thing, so we need not need this. But in residential also, restaurants and hotel comes. So in there, we do have a bathtubs over here. But as if now, no over here. So this is 1 per 100. What is this? This is a drinking fountain, what you see. And others, if you see, this is 1 servicing. As it's an educational thing, they might bring the defense or something. So we need 1 servicing for them. Moreover, let's see one more thing over here. Now let's talk about a residential thing. So if you see in here over here, an apartment house, this is 1 per dwelling unit. Now what do you mean by this? That means per family we need 1 WC, 1 laboratory and 1 dwelling unit. Again in terms of what? The bathtub for sure we need over here. And nothing in terms of what? The drinking fountain, no need. And 1 kitchen sink per dwelling unit. Okay. And moreover, let's see one more thing. Nothing but if you talk about business, if you're falling under this category, assembly, in this also we do have subcategories. If you see over here, so this is A1, A2, A3 and all this. So you need to check you're falling under which category, and these are the basic things over here like WC, lavatories, bathtub, drinking fountains and others. So these are the minimum number of required plumbing fixtures. Now One can find out the number of fixtures in such a manner, like if you know the number of people, and how you can find out the number of people. For example, as I just now said, thus the architect or the main contractor has not been given us the fixtures, and he said that you proceed up with this. So do not get worried. I can make use of this table, and I can proceed in this manner, saying this. Okay, I have taken this values from this XYZ code, like I'm doing right now with 2009 International Plumbing Code. So I can just find out the occupancy over here. And only thing what I need to find out apart from this is, moreover, I need to find out the furniture layout, from where I can find out the number of people in the project. Okay, when I find out, for example, I got to know this is like now I'll say you, for example, I'm going with theater and all this, and here he is saying 125. I got 300 people in male and 300 people in female. So what I need to do, one per 125. What that means, in 125 people, one WC is more than enough as per the probability. Same in female, one per 65. That means in 65 female, one WC is sufficient as per the probability. Now this values is as per the probability. That's what I said, you know. Now I hope you got what is the use of the codes over here. Now there is 300 people means I need to go for sure. I actually, if I go with two WCs, it's 250 only, but I need to go for three for sure, because it no problem, because this is 125, but I have only 300 people. But for 50 people, what about 50 people? Because if I go with two WCs over here in the mail, this is 125, 125. This goes to 250, but again 50 remains. So for safer side, I'll be going with three WCs in this theater in terms of male toilets, and in the female area and the toilet, what I'll be doing, I'll be having three WCs over there, like 300 and 300. So in this male toilets and female toilets, three WCs and three WCs. Same laboratories, one per 200. Again, I'll be going with two laboratories in terms of male and in terms of female. Why? Because one per 200, but actual things is what I'm having is 300 male and 300 female capacity in that theater. Okay, and now in the bathtubs, no need of bathtub, it's not residential, so no need of this. And drinking fountain, one per 500. So if this is 600 people, I'll be again going for two drinking fountains, okay, and one servicing. So in this manner, I can find out the minimum number of required plumbing fixtures as per this code. Okay, so this is the things over here what we have seen.